Hey folks, how you going? We're back with something that I'm really fucking excited about. That's the Milk 5, turns out they're called not Milk V, Milk 5 Duo Module 01 Evaluation Board. So you can buy just the modules on their own, but this eval board is what I wanted, it's what I got, and it's what I'm really excited about. Essentially, it's like the Duo SG2000 chip that's on the little Duos. I'll grab some out and show you soon, on a full SBC board. So super low power with all the I.O. We're going to get into it. We're going to test it out. It's Duo S image compatible, so it should have most of the Duo S functionality. And they released a new image just in the 1st of August. So we'll install that. We'll benchmark it. We'll test its power consumption, which should be super low. We'll look at the pros and cons of it and anything else that comes up in the meantime. Let's get into it. Later me here now. I actually forgot to say thanks to PCBWay for sponsoring this video. They're continuing to put out the good stuff. You can see that there is a design contest on at the moment, and I'm working with them on making some awesome new projects, including a product for the Milk V Duo. So more about that at the end of the video, about 19 minutes into it, or maybe 20 minutes into it, depending on how long this is. But thanks to PCBWay, click the link below to get 5% off your first purchase with them, and let me know if you have any questions. Cheers. All right, folks, it's the next day, and I really can't be asked with YouTube videos today, so this is going to be pretty short and dirty and maybe sweet. We'll see. I was really excited about this board, but today's just been a shit day, to be honest. How's your day been? Stop right now. Leave a comment below. Let me know how your day's been. If someone's day's been really interesting, I might even mention it in the next video. So if you make videos yourself, get a free shout out. But either way, I'd love to know how your day's going. It's Saturday here. And we're looking at the Duo Module 01, as I recorded yesterday and probably put in the intro just before this. Comes in a little plastic case, sorry, Duo Module 01 eval board. Little plastic case, which a very smart cookie recently told me they use as the product case, like literally just drill out some holes for the connections and you're off to the races. But I'm actually pretty excited about this board for a number of reasons. I really like the Duo series. So if we actually go back slightly, we've got the OG Duo. This is the Duo Classic, as I call it, or the Duo 64. It's got a CV1008B chip from memory. These, I believe, are what then became the SG chip. So it's VTech turned into SoftCore or something. I don't fully understand. But it's just got 64 meg of RAM. It's got a bit of processing power. They're all RISC-V, of course. But... sorry, and I keep saying Milk V still, they're Milk 5, I meant to say, but these are the OG Duos that I've got a lot of in stock, work really well. I've killed a lot of them, but I use them for heaps of projects because they are just so low power. Link below or up there somewhere to the video about these. After that, you've got the Duo 256. So this one has the SG2000, which in itself is a very interesting processor, the SG2000 and the SG2002. Sorry, this has got the SG2002. Two very similar boards. This one doesn't have any SPI flash. It's got 256 meg of RAM. They're still using their crappy non-standard camera connector, but this has one tops of NPU or TPU power, whereas the SG2000 only has half tops, but then has 512 meg of RAM, which is where we get, this one's dead, huh? No, I was using this one works, sweet, resurrected. Then we get into the Duo S, or the Duo 512 meg. So this has got the SG2000, and that's got some glare in it, and it has a lot of different things. So it's got Ethernet on board, you don't need the adapter for it. It's got the secondary USB port, you've got their crappy camera connector, you've got a normal connector, and your headers are split over two. It also has Wi-Fi built in, as you can see from that little connector there, and there is a PoE board for this, which might turn up one day. That would be really lovely. We've all been waiting months for it. Now these SG 2000 chips also have an ARM processor and a RISC-V processor, and there is a boot select switch here where you can choose which one it boots, but they only have 0.5 tops of processing power. I actually forget, I think the 256 has the ARM core as well, and there is now development for this. So if we have a quick look over at here and we scroll down a bit, you'll see there is information. Well, anyway, somewhere there is information about the ARM image, and that's what's starting here in their GitHub repo for SDK v2. This is where you'll be able to download and build an ARM image. And as you can see, it's got a newer version of U-boot and build root and a couple of other things. They might even bump the Linux kernel. That would be nice. So you've got the ARM and the RISC-V option. Now, everyone speculates about why that may be. I think it's quite handy if you're writing, you know, embedded software to test it on both. They don't both run at the same time. It's where that switch is when you boot it, or where one of their pins are on this one. I can't remember when you boot it. So now, the next evolution is the Duo module. So let's have a closer look at this. Where did I lose my key? Well, let's go back and change my camera focus to 50. Sorry, that's my current process. So here, if I turn off this ridiculously bright light, you can see the Duo Module 01. That's got the SG2000, the same as the, Duo S has. So as you can see, it's got 512 meg of RAM. It also has 8 gig of eMMC built in. The Wi-Fi antenna connects directly to the module. It's got that 1 teraops of processing power and those 2 cores, plus the 8051. I keep neglecting to say that, but it's pretty awesome that it's got an 8051 in there. Now, the documentation for this back in Firefox land is not very built out yet. They do kind of, they've got a bit of a copy and paste. They've got the initial data sheet, a link to someone else's store where you can buy it, and a mention of using the Duo S image. That's all well and good. Now, if we go back, let's change this to like 25 or something and have a look at this board. Still need to hit that light off, I think. It's got a fair bit going on. So you've got dual 10100 Ethernet, 4 USB 2.0 ports. You've got an audio connector there, which looks like it's going to be a 4-pin. That should be a 4-pin. So it should be stereo plus mic in there. USB-C for power. You have an LCD interface there. You've got the camera and camera interface there, the same as the Duo S. You've got your two sets of, you've only got one set of the headers there. So they're kind of your standard, what's that going to be, 22 pin header. You've got your boot selection switch, which is ARM or RISC-V. You've got what I'm going to assume is a speaker connector there. Unknown connectors there. I might have to trace those back. Your SD card. And that's about the long and the short of it. So it's a pretty standard, simple board. If we compare it quickly to the Luckfox, you can see it's not quite that credit card form factor. It is a little bit different. I'm just going to change focus back. I've got to build out a little device to do this for me. They've obviously used a gold finish. You've got a couple of standoff mount points. There are some test pads around. These actually, they look like fiducials from manufacturing. And it comes with a little Wi-Fi antenna. Now, there is that 4-pin connection there, which I'm going to assume is for the PoE module, if it supports it. The designation is MC003IOB V1.1. So we've already got a first revision of the board, but also it's treating it as an IO board, which is really interesting. The actual product code, as you'll see on my shop, because I do have some of these left. I've got 3 left in stock at the moment, 10 more coming, is completely different. It's like E8W1P, I'd forget. These pins, I'm guessing, are just power. That's pretty standard on a few boards I've seen recently. But all in all, it looks pretty neat. I really like it. It's at a good price point for what it is. And the fact that it gives you all of these interfaces to experiment with the Duo before you go, say, smaller to the Duo S, or just buy the chips on your own, which you can. I don't keep them in stock, but that is definitely an option. I might get the Duo modules in stock. They're BGA, pain in the dick to solder. But you can see these are just castellated edges, so they should actually be pretty straightforward to use in a project. Now, what I don't know is if these come with any image on them out of the factory. So I'm going to boot it up and see what it does. You know, I don't even need that light. What if I just put it right up the top? I'm still trying to get this workshop just right, and it's a slow process. So first and foremost, let's grab a USB cable out. Grab two for now. Grab one of these power cables. They're meant for the pintsels, but they work great. They do transmit data, just not well. If you ever use them for data and you're starting to get weird errors, just try a different cable. Now, we'll put this one in there. We're going to sit a Duo under there so you don't have the horrid reflection and can read it. Type C in. And another cable for Type-C out. Let's see if we can get that positioned nicely. Duo S to the rescue. No, it just, yeah, close enough. So off the bat, when we boot this up, whether or not it's got an image in it on it, we'll find out. So you can see here, there is a red LED and a blue LED. That's gonna be your status. 0.4 amps, we've got it set to the RISC-V side. 0.04 amps, sorry, it's drawing 0.23 watts. It is not doing anything. Nobody's home. So I'm gonna grab this SD card out. I don't think I've got any of my good Lexar ones. I've left them all in things that I've put back away again. So I'm gonna quickly flash this and then we'll get back to it and we'll see what it does when it boots. All right, that is done. This is flashed. Now, yes, I know this has the 8 gig eMMC. However, as always, they're neglecting, you know, us Linux users or even Mac users in the information here. So you can see to burn the eMMC, you need this CVI burn tool. Now, if you do have a Windows computer handy and I don't here, then that tool is actually under the 1.1.0 release. You can see that here, including the driver. There is nothing that I could find for Linux on Mac at this point. That being said, I didn't look too hard because, as I said at the start, I can't be asked. So going back here, we're going to pop that eMMC in. We're going to turn that display back up and we're going to see how it goes this time when it boots by plugging into there. All right, immediately consuming a lot more power, 140 milliamps, 149 milliamps there. So it's definitely doing something more. What we want to see though is that blue light blinking, because that's its little blinky routine that at least lets you know that it's gotten to the user land. There you go. So that is running. That was a pretty quick boot as far as I can tell. What I have done as well is downloaded this 1.1.2 image. They've fixed a few little things. There are still limitations, like the SG chips not supporting ping pong, no support for Arduino with the Duo S, which means this doesn't support Arduino yet. That's a bit of a big failure in my books. And it doesn't, the Duo Arduino firmware doesn't support the camera, but it is constantly being developed. You can see they're committing to it pretty much every week at last I checked. So yeah, last week was the last commit there. It is very active. They are continuing to develop it and they do make very good products, and they admit when they make mistakes, like the Mealies, which is probably got another revision now they're finally fixed. This though works out the box, which is excellent. Booted, it draws about 160 milliamps, which is super, super low power. So the last thing I'm going to do now is grab out a CP2104, which, if we go back to this camera, I've got down here my little collection of bridges. So I'll get that out. We're going to connect to the debug ports on this. If I can figure them out, I'm going to have to go to the schematic and have a look. And then we're going to jump onto the console and just see if everything's normal, see if there's anything fancy hanging around. And hold for that one. I'll be back in a sec. All right, so what we've got here is everything still powered up as normal. I'll give that a little flick so we can watch the power. Now, there was no documentation on this, but I just assumed it was the same pins as the Duo S under there, and it looks like I was right. So CP2104, I'm just using the ground pin there so that there's a common reference, and that's dangling up there to my computer for USB. Now, if you're using Linux, you do just want to set these settings so that turns off the stop bit and the flow control, and then you can screen to it with 1150-200 on Windows. If you're using PuTTY, those settings are in there. So now if we jump in, I'm about to hit the reset button on the board in 3, 2, 1, clickety clack, good song, and off she goes. That's booting pretty quickly. There is a bad system call somewhere in there, which is interesting. That looked like it was to do with the, yep, that's very fair. Looks like it was to do with DHCP or networking, but that was essentially booted in 10 seconds. So the quick usual checks, we are using 21 meg of RAM. That is tiny. You can probably optimize that too. That's awesome. Linux kernel 5.10, kind of expected. 6.1, 6.10 would be lovely, but beggars can't be choosers. It has not expanded the SD card. I'd much prefer if it did, but that leaves us wiggle room, of course. Interesting the way it lays that out as well, but I don't even know if, no, this can't be booting off the onboard eMMC because it did nothing when we just tried to use that. This must be booting off that. Now, I wonder if that shows up as, No, so the MMC isn't really showing up there, which is odd. So be it. See, it's sitting there not doing very much. It's got init running. It's probably, it's got NTPD, DNS, DHCP, not too much going on. So I think that RAM usage can definitely be optimized. If you turn off a lot of that, you just won't need it. This is a build root build, as always. Oh, that's weird. Alrighty, and what else do we want to look at? There is going to be... Yep, there we go. That's what we wanted to see. Build root. Okay, fairly recent. Can probably get newer than that. Now, we can't do a lot of the standard tests that we'll do, like running Geekbench. I might actually try. I'm going to have to turn on a bucket load of swap, and I've got enough space on the SD card. I'm probably going to pause this though, and I might try to find the MMC. So just hold up a tick. I'm going to have a look at that. Yeah, so what I realized is that using the SD image doesn't have the device tree configured for the EMMC. That's almost certainly what's going on there. Could modify it. I could flash this with Windows back at the other place and come back to it, but I really can't be asked. So the last thing I'm going to see there is we do have one Ethernet interface, and we've got RNDIS on our USB interface, and the wireless interface. It's interesting that not both interfaces are enabled by default, but I'd assume here that there is going to be... I reckon it's because it's the GOS image, and the GOS only has the one network port. So we'd probably need to modify the device tree for that as well, or wait for them to do a release that adds everything you need. Let's have a quick look and see if it picks up the USB ports. I'm going to plug in random SanDisk card and... All right, I'm just trying all the USB ports. Alrighty, I didn't seem to get anything on any of these USB ports, which is quite interesting. That is probably also the device tree. So I really do think a new image is going to need to be cut for this. Otherwise, you don't have full access. Now, if we go back and have a look at the documentation, you can see that there is information here on usage of the USB Type-A interface. So let's go and have a quick look of that again. If we go, what scripts do we have?